Pompeo blasts Biden, administration has kowtowed to hostage-taking China regime. Former Secretary of State Mike Pompeo on Sunday denounced the Biden administration's slavish track record of bowing to China. During an appearance on Sunday's The Cats Roundtable on WABC-AM, Pompeo said that whether or not China follows through on its rumored plans to use Bagram Airfield in Afghanistan as a base for future operations, China will do whatever it needs to expand its power. They'll find a way to get a foothold, they will expand their capacity to project power from that place, Pompeo said. Pompeo, who was Secretary of State in the Trump administration, was a strong voice denouncing China's economic and military expansionist tactics, told host John Katzimatidis that the Biden administration has bent too far to obey China. This administration, too, John, and these are connected ideas, they've kowtowed to China, and we're beginning to see an appeasement policy there, he continued. Pompeo focused upon a recent administration decision to play ball with China in an arrangement that saw the Justice Department cut a deal with Meng Wanzhou, 49, the chief finance officer of Huawei Technologies, to drop fraud charges against her. In return, two Canadian citizens who had been accused of espionage were immediately freed by China. Last week there was a decision made to allow the Justice Department to drop charges against the CFO for Huawei, a company that violated our Iranian sanctions and a company that is deeply committed to stealing the private information of every American citizen, he said. For the life of me, I can't understand why they let her off the hook, he continued. Meng had been arrested during the Trump administration. The Chinese had taken two Canadians hostage. I think we all need to think hard about that. The Chinese took hostages to get someone back to their country. This is no different than the way the Iranians behave, he explained. Pompeo said that even the Biden administration's climate change efforts, spearheaded by John Kerry, work in China's favor and against America. He noted that hostile countries like China and Afghanistan can determine whether the U.S. can access the materials needed to build the electric vehicles Biden wants Americans to buy. It's really something, when I hear former Secretary of State John Kerry talk about climate change and that we will build these batteries. It's essentially handing the U.S. economy over to the Chinese Communist Party, Pompeo said. I hope this administration isn't so narrowly focused on climate change that they forget that these resources, the things that go into batteries, these rare earth minerals, are an essential component of American national security as well.